Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Medical Simple by Hardik Shah. Today we'll have a discussion on the menstrual cycle. As such, you all are aware of organs in the female reproductive system. Majorly it comprises of four organs. The lowest organ is known as vagina, followed by vagina there is a uterus. From the top of a uterus, two fallopian tubes are arising out. And end of the uterus, end of the fallopian tubes, the two ovaries are there. Come to the important part, and that is the menstrual cycle. Menstrual cycle having a four different phases. Which are those four phases? The first phase is the menstrual phase. The second phase is follicular phase. The third phase is ovulation phase. And the fourth is a luteal phase. The total length of the menstrual cycle is 28 days, which may range from 24 to 34 days. In all different phases of a menstrual cycle, majorly changes are taking place in ovaries and the endometrium. Endometrium is the inner lining of the uterus. Come to the first phase of menstrual cycle, and that is a menstrual phase. Menstrual phase is also known as periods or menses. During the menstrual phase, the endometrial lining of a uterus remains very thin. Why do the endometrial linings of the uterus remain thin during the menstrual phase? Because during the entire menstrual phase, there is a shedding of endometrial lining. Endometrium is breaking and it is coming out through the vagina. This is how during the menstrual phase, a blood loss is happening through the vagina nearly for 3 to 7 days with an average of 5 days. Average blood loss during the 5 days of the menstrual phase is nearly around 40 to 50 ml with a range of 25 to 60 ml, 25 to 65 ml. Moving on, there is another phase, and that is a follicular phase. During the follicular phase, what happens with the ovaries? Ovaries starts producing a female sexual hormone known as estrogen. This estrogen starts making the endometrial wall again, the wall which was already lost during the menstrual phase. This is how there is a regaining of an endometrial wall in a follicular phase. At the same time, the endometrial wall formation, that process of endometrial wall formation is known as proliferation, which lasts for 6 to 13 days. At the same time, the ovary also contains lakhs of follicles inside, and every follicle has having an egg or ovum inside. During the follicular phase, which lasts from day 6 to day 13, each ovary pick up nearly about 25 to 30 follicles, and they starts growing. Since the follicles are growing from primordial stage to the Graafian stage, this process is known as Follicularogenesis. So two things are happening during the follicular phase. One is formation of endometrium under the influence of estrogen released by ovary. And the second, there is a Follicularogenesis. That means the follicles, 25 to 30 follicles in each ovary starts growing. The third phase is known as what? Ovulation phase. Now, what happens during the ovulation phase? Let us pick it up from a follicular phase where we already know that 30 follicles in each ovary is growing. So, put together 60 follicles in each ovary is growing. Out of 60 follicles, only one follicle would be picked up by the ovary. This one follicle will become a Graafian follicle. What is Graafian follicle? One follicle will rupture Once the follicle ruptures, it is happening on day 14. Once the follicle is ruptured, can see here a ruptured follicle, it starts releasing egg into the fallopian tube. This is how the egg is released into the fallopian tube. Once egg is released into the fallopian tube, the process of releasing an egg is known as what? Ovulation. So, end of the ovulation, there are two things. The one, the ovum is already present within the fallopian tube, and at the same time, now you have a ruptured follicle. This ruptured follicle is known as what? Corpus luteum. So, coming to the fourth phase named luteal phase. As we know, the end of the third phase, that is ovulation phase, you have a ruptured graafian follicle named as corpus luteum. Now, this corpus luteum is the major source of another female sexual hormone named progesterone. This progesterone is responsible for making an endometrial wall more secretory in nature, so that this endometrial wall will prepare for taking a pregnancy. So progesterone prepares the endometrial wall for the pregnancy by providing more blood vessels to the endometrium. This phase, the luteal phase, lasts from day 15 to day 28 of the cycle. What happens at the end of the luteal phase? Up at 26th day, the corpus luteum, in the absence of pregnancy, of course, on 26th day, the corpus luteum starts collapsing. Once a corpus luteum starts collapsing, automatically progesterone, which was released by the corpus luteum, become very negligible. Now, this progesterone was the one who provided nourishment and the blood vessels to the endometrium. Now, since the progesterone is not available in the blood, the endometrium, which was receiving the blood vessels from a progesterone, now start shedding again, and woman enters in the phase 1. This is how the blood loss through the vagina starts again. So, this is how the cycle continues. Thank you.